didn't even get to cross.
Good morning and what is up sa inyo mga gamers, it's your boy Zero and I hope all of you are doing great today and welcome back yet again to another chapter of Sekiro Shadow Dies Twice. And for today's chapter we are going to continue our infiltration to Ashina Castle to look for Lord Kuro, our main objective. So let us go on ahead and begin our rescue operation.
Thank you.
魔殿、あれは一体何なのです？
落ち水、そう呼ばれています。
あれがアシナの秘策だというのですか？
はい、飲んだ者は生中には死なぬ、いえ、死ねぬようになります。そして落ち水もまた。
その源は流因にあるというのだな。
はい、
エマ殿、私には流因が尊いものだととても思えぬ。
And so I would like to end this chapter right here, mga gamers, and let's talk about this today's chapter, shall we?
Okay,
first, or the beginning of the chapter, we found the
Shishaga,
which we found a prayer beat to increase our health bar, and we fought this troublesome mini boss named Ashina Elite Jinsuke Saze. And he is a very troublesome boss and gave me a total of 5 deaths, which makes it very, very hard because, you know, I never had the chance to attack him due to this pattern of attacks. So luckily I use my brain. I noticed that every time he slash his sword, the sheath of the sword starts to glow. It's about to attack for a slight second. And I noticed also that he only have one type of combat style, so that leaves him with only one pattern of attack, which make him very vulnerable. So I managed to defeat this boss just by blocking his attacks, because as you can see, every time he slashes his sword, the sheath of the sword starts blinking. There's a slight second before he makes a move. So when he starts that, so every time I saw that sheath blink, I start to block. That's how I managed to kill this boss. It was very troublesome for some pips, I guess, because that slash is very, very irritating due to that damage and that composure. Even though you block it, it still costs a lot of still cause damage even though you block it. Don't know why. It's kind of bit cheating. So for me, this has to be one of the hardest miniboss that I fought, or probably the hardest one. This is the first miniboss that I had 5 deaths. So yeah, that will be pretty much it for this chapter. So we're still gonna continue to look for Lord Kuro in the next chapter, because we still don't know where he is. I think we might find him at the top of this tower, or this castle, I mean. So I hope you stay tuned, and I will see you on the next chapter. Hope you guys enjoy, and thanks for watching. Stay safe, love you all. This is Zero Gaming, over and out. Peace.